Hi friends, in this lecture let us simulate three-phase full converter. As a simple layman, I like to see six thyristors in a three-phase full converter, and the input is AC and output is DC. So I need to provide three phases. For each phase I need to provide an AC source, and I like to put resistance as the load. After that, we will implement for RL load, and then we will implement for RLE load also. So first let us see how can we first draw the circuit here. Let me take the components. As we know, we need to take thyristors, six thyristors. So Simulink is one toolbox, and Sim Power Systems is another toolbox where we like to use more out of these two toolboxes only. So let us go ahead with these things. Electrical sources, I want AC voltage source, and let me go ahead with power electronic elements, that is detailed thyristor, and I want one resistor elements, so that is series RLC branch is there and load is also there. If you take the load, you need to give the load in terms of kilowatt or kVAR, I mean kilo volt ampere. So in those ratings we need to give the values, but for this series RLC branch is good because here we can give the values directly, RLC values. So let me take this out. What are the other elements I need? Yeah, I require a pulse generator. So let me go ahead with that. Pulse generator is available in Simulink. Commonly used blocks. Is it there? No, it's not there. So in sources, it will be there. Yeah, pulse generator. So that's all. These are the sufficient things to make a three-phase full converter. And I should definitely have a power GUI block. Yeah, this is power GUI block. I like to keep my power GUI block in discrete mode, as we are dealing with mainly the discrete things. So this is the thing. Yeah, first let me turn this. Rotate this. Actually, this is in this way, and I need to rotate in counterclockwise direction. Yes, this is correct. And let me change the name also. This is my T1. So this is T2, yeah, T3, T4 should be here, T5 should be here, and T6 should be here. That's all. So T1, T2 should be here, and T3 should be here, T5 should be here. Yes, this is T4, T6. And this is T2. So these are the elements connected in different things. And this is pulse generator. Let me nomenclate this as, let me write it as Z1. Yes, this is the gate pulse. So let me write it as Z1. Z1, Z2, G3, G4, G5, G5 and G6. Yes, I think, do you know this or not? Let me explain this part. To get the same block one more time, that means I need to copy and I need to paste. Instead of that, you need to click on this and take the right click on it and just move it and just drop there, so that it will be copy and paste. This is the one of the shortcuts and to copy and paste any element. Okay, so let me delete this part. So now let me connect it. These three are connected in this way. As you already know this, in your power electronics, you have this these things. If you have any doubts, I will explain. Please write in the comment box so that I can explain you in a better manner also. Yeah, this is the structure where we need to connect in this way. Let me change this part also. This, let me take this as V1. Right click, V2. Right click, drag and drop so that it will come. One more block. And the positive things are given to phases. Each phase, phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3 respectively. And the negative things. Okay, let me make these three come down. Down, down, down. Okay. Okay, okay. Cancel. Yes. And the third one is given to third phase. Oh, sorry. Yes, third one is connected to third phase, and the these are connected in this way. These three are shorted here, and I need to put a ground here so that we are providing phase voltages here to each phase. Okay, we have done this one. Okay, let me take the first, let me connect this part, load part. This is right flip clock. It should be clockwise. Yes, I want only R load. So let me select only R here. Let it be. We will change it in the due course. And this is the load. So let me write only load here, as I can keep on changing it to some R load or RL load or E load. This is the connection for this. This is DC and this is AC part. So let me have one ground here. So for that one, I need to go here. Please let me write ground, G-R-O-U-N-D. Ground will be there. Yeah, this is the ground. And let me use this ground. Yeah, need to connect here. Yes. So let me make all these just up so that I can connect my gate pulses over there. Gate pulse 1 is connected like this. Okay. This is gate pulse 1 and gate pulse 2 is here. So this is 2. We take this as gate pulse 3. Make it a little bit upper. This is gate pulse 5. And this is gate pulse 6, and this is gate pulse 2. This is gate pulse 4. There are so many improvements in this structure. You can, if you have good experience over this, you can connect it very nicely in a shorter manner, maybe in very short things. You can take only one pulse and you can make the other pulses to have some what we call as some phase shift, and all these things can be done very nicely once you have good knowledge in simulations. Let me make the whole circuit down. Let me make it upper. Let me make whole thing come left side, as I need to take measurement part also. And let me take this here. Let me take this at the center. Yeah, now I want to take the measurement part, as we need to see the graphs and all these things. So first, measurement means, let me take the multimeter here. Multimeter, voltage meter. So instead of taking current measurement, voltage measurement, let me take directly the multimeter. And for multimeter, you can see my video, earlier video, and I will post the same thing in my description box. You can easily get it. So here, let me take one scope. I want to take some very less components. Yeah, this is the scope. Control check. Okay, again it is coming. Okay, no problem. Never ever get panic while doing the simulations. So everything come up with only if anything went wrong, you can go ahead with Control Z option so that it will go back to the previous step. Okay, let me see this. Actually, I want voltage here across V1. So even current also, voltage is here. Okay, current is passing through this. So I can take this current as input current. So let me take this, show this. Okay, the input current can be calculated by measurement here. Here is one measurement. So we can take the same help of this one, show measurement port. Okay, anyhow, let us discuss with this and let us first go ahead with this voltage source, whether it has come here or not. Yeah, it has come here. Okay, and this one, I want to see these parts very keenly. I want to observe these things, voltage and current across the even what we call as load. Apply here and okay, that's all. So let us go ahead with these things. Let me have one mux here, as I have three components here. So demux should be there. Sorry, demux, as my input is only one and I need to divide into three parts. Three parts, and I want to make it little bigger, and I want to make it into three axis. Apply. Okay, and I want to connect this. There is one shortcut here, need to click here, control and click here, so that each part will be connected like this. So now this is the circuit for there are components, source is there, this is the source part, and these are the components, and these are the gate pulses, and this is the load. Everything is finished. Now we need to apply some voltage here. So let me have it, this is 100 volt peak, it's okay, it's perfect. Let me change it to 50 hertz here, frequency, and stopping time is not required, and phase delay is 0 for the phase 1. So let me take apply and OK. For the second phase, peak voltage is 100, perfect, and frequency is 50. Okay, perfect. But the phase delay is let me take it as -120 degrees. For the proper phase shift, we need to take -120 degrees. For V3, I need 100 is okay, frequency is 50, and the phase delay is 120 degrees. So these are the things we need to apply here. So now I have three phase supply applied to the rectifier having 120 degree phase shift from each other. So once this was finished, so this is 100 volt. Let me take this as maybe 10, so that, or we can call it as even 5 also to apply. So I want to see this part. This is how we need to apply the gate pulses. This is very, very important part we need to take care here. As we know, I have 6 pulses. Let me increase the font so that you can see this with clear eyes. Yeah, this is the thing. Let me change the color. It is 4. The color, let me take it as blue. Okay, it's good. Yeah, actually I have six thyristors, and I have 360 degree of things. So I have 6 thyristors. I need to cover 360 degree here. So what I can do means I can divide 360 equally to these 6 thyristors, so that I can say that for each thyristor the conduction period is 60 degree. And once this is completed, now I need to give the pulses here. So as we have already studied in power electronics, this is three-phase supply. So three-phase supply can be started from 30 degree phase shift onwards, and there is a reason for that, because after 30 degree only T1 is going to be more voltage, I mean it is in forward bias compared to some other thyristors T3 and T5 in the positive group. Actually, the explanation for this three-phase full converter will be available in my next video. So I like to start videos on power electronics also. In that video I will explain each and everything. So meanwhile, please go ahead with any of the power electronic textbook so that you can come to know why it has to be started from 30 degree onwards. So once it is started from 30 degree, so for G1 it is started from 30 degree. So 30 degree is equal to 0, alpha is 0, alpha 0, because it has to start from 30 degree, then only T1 will be in forward bias. So once I have given pulses at 30 degree, so the alpha should be 0. If I want to give alpha 30 degree, so 30 plus 30, so I need to give omega t as 60 degree. That we need to keep in mind, so that once this part is over, so first I want to keep my firing angle alpha is equal to 0 here, 0 degree, and I want to set each and every gate pulse accordingly. We just check it out how we can fix the pulses here. So this is the concept. So for G1, for gate pulse 1, I need to fire at 30 degree onwards. So first I want to make alpha equal to 0. So definitely I like to fire it at 30 degree. So once you know G1 is at 30 degree, so G2 should be, actually we already discussed 360 degrees will be divided into 6 parts. So each thyristor can conduct for 60 degree. So G1 means T1 can conduct from 30 degrees to plus 60 up to 90 degree. So G1 has to be conduct at 30 degree plus 60 degree. So 30 degree plus 60 degree. Similarly, G3 can conduct from, G3 can also be conducted from 30 degree plus 60 degree, 30 degree plus 60 degree plus again 60 degree. So in this way it will go on. Let me rewrite the entire thing, not an issue. G4 is equal to 30 degree plus 60 degree plus 60 degree plus one more 60 degree. Yeah, this is for G4. And let me go ahead with G5. G5 is equal to 30 degree plus 60 degree plus 60 degree plus 60 degree. All will come up. Let me copy this and paste here, and one more 60 degree will come. That is the concept. Okay, this is the concept here. One more 60 will come up here. And for next part, for G6, the entire part will come. So up to 30 degree to 60 degree, T1 will conduct. From 90 degree to plus 60 degree, T2 will conduct. This is for T3 and this is for T4. And after that, T5 will conduct. Yeah, T5 will conduct for one more 60 degree. And then T6 will start conducting. So these are the things we need to incorporate. Okay. So let us incorporate all these things in this gate pulse. Pulse generator, we have already discussed how to put these things in one of our videos, pulse generator. So amplitude is one, it's okay. Period means this is the time period. So we are using 50 hertz cycle, so obviously the time period should be 1/50, that means 0.02 seconds, and the pulse width should be, let me take it as 50%. So phase delay should be in seconds, so it's not in degrees but it is in seconds. So we need to take the conversion. Let us do it. Conversion, how to convert these things. We know that 360 degree is a full cycle, that means this is the full time period, so 0.02 seconds. So what about 30 degree? 30 degree equal to how much? 30 degree equal to how much? So this is very simple, 360 divided by 30 is equal to 0.02 divided by question mark, that means let me take it as x. So what happened? So 360 by 60 is 12, which is equal to 0.02 by x, which implies x is equal to 0.02 by 12, that means 0.01 divided by 6. So the clear cut conversion is 0.01 means it resembles 180 degree. So if you want 30 degree, it should be 180 divided by 6, that means 0.01 by 6. Obviously this is in second. So this is the conversion, so we need to adopt here, so which is equal to 0.01 by 6. And for the next step, how to proceed? The next step is 0.01 by 6. That means it is 0.01 by 6 is the 30 degree. That means this part is over now. And plus 60 degree means double of this part. Double of this part is 2 times of 0.01 by 6. That means 2 and 3, 6 will go in 3 times. So it will be 0.01 by 3. So this is the thing. So in this way we need to keep up my G2's phase delay. Okay, let us do all these things. So first observe here. Next, as we know, 30 degree means this part, copy and paste simply. Plus this is 60 degree, we have already finished. 60 degree means 0.01 by 3 and one more 60 is there now, so it is 0.01 by. For this one, we can simply write 2 into 0.01 by 6, sorry, 3. So this is the simple concept. So in this way, we can write it. So after that, we can simply add one more 60 degree here. That means one more 60 means we have already 260s. So let me add one more 60 here, so into 3 simply. So similarly, I need to add one more 60 here, this is into 4. Similarly for the last one, I need to add one more 60 here, so this is 5. So in this way we need to do all these things. From G1 to G5 we need to convert these things. So in this way we need to put all these phase delays. So for G1 the phase delay is very simple, this part, let me bold it, this part 0.01 by 6. Okay, so yeah, 0.01 by 6 simply. So I put it as omega t equal to 30 degree and alpha equal to 0 degree. And coming to the next part, G2, oh it has come here, let me take it to some other side. Yes, so G2 will be like this, 0.01 by 6 plus 0.01 by 3. Okay, let us see here. 1 is okay in 0.02, and this will be 50, and this will be 0.01 divided by 6 plus 0.01 divided by 3. Let me copy this part. This is correct. And coming to G3, yeah, 1 is okay, and this should be 0.02, and this should be 50. And here I need to write this part, and here it should be 2 into within bracket 0.01 by 3. That's all. This is G3. Now coming to G4, for G4, 1 is okay, and this should be 0.02, this should be 50. This is not sample based, it's time based, and the phase delay is like this. So this is G4, so I need to keep 3 here, 3 into 0.01. Don't solve this, okay? This is the very good and easy method to resolve this problem. This is 50, and this part is like this. So put a bracket here. This is G5, so you need to keep 4 here. That's all. And coming to G6, 0.02 and 50 here, and this will be 4 times of this, so it will be 5 times, as this is the last one, 6th part. Yeah, that's all. Okay, so this is the conversion. So at alpha equal to 0, we have done all these things. So let us see, we will just run it and see what will happen. This is 10, simulation time is 10 seconds, so this is not required. Actually, the time is 0.02 seconds is the one cycle. So let us hardly take 5 cycles. So 5 into 0.02, that may come around 0.1. Okay, that's more than sufficient. So 0.1, let me keep it 0.1 here. You must close. Okay, before that we need to close the dialog box. Actually, one of the dialog box may be open, maybe this part or this or this. Close all and just run here. There is a problem here, invalid setting for the input port dimension demux. Okay, actually we have set it, but we haven't given any value to selected measurements. So let me keep all the values in selected measurements. Yeah, these are the values. So let me close this. Now let me start. Yeah, let me make it bigger. So auto scale. So this is very nice structure we got here. This is what we call as the output of the three phase full converter. The output will be like this. Explanation how we need to, we can make our pulse generators to work in a sequential manner as per our requirement. So this is the explanation for three phase full converter if the load is R load. And we can also extend the same explanation for RL load also. So in this way we can get the this is the explanation for three phase full converter. So these are the sources, how to put the sources here, and they should be grounded, and these are the thyristors, so no explanation for the for them. So we already know how to arrange them, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. And there are pulse generators G1, G2, G3, G4, G5, G6, and this is the load. So this is the explanation for this power circuit. And once this is completed, multimeter has been installed, and we have taken wherever we want voltage and currents, and those are installed here, and those are selected here, so that those waveforms will be shown in this scope. So how to put the gate pulses, and this is the explanation for the gate pulses. how to put them in a sequential and better manner. So this is the complete scenario of simulating three phase full converter. If you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends and family, and kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications. Thank you. Thank you very much.